Greetings to all my dear students. Let's start studying subject computer, chapter 2, working with charts in MS Excel. In this lesson, we will study the types of charts, then what are the components of charts, how to create a charts and how to format charts in MS Excel. So let's start. So dear student, first understand what is the meaning of charts. A chart is a visual representation of data in a worksheet. A chart displays complex and large amount of data in an easily understandable diagram format. A chart also displays the relationship between different values of data in a worksheet. When we make changes in the data, the changes are also reflected in the chart. Now in MS Excel, there are different types of options are available to the chart group in the Insert tab. So these are different types of charts available in MS Excel. This is a column chart, then this is bar chart, this is pie chart, this is donut chart, line chart, area chart, scatter chart and spider chart. So let us learn how to understand these types of chart one by one. So here is the list of the chart type and its description. The line chart, it shows the continuous trend in data across a specific time period. So this is a line chart. Yes. Next is column chart. It shows changes in data at specific time interval. It is also useful in comparing data of multiple items across specific time intervals. You studied these types of chart, how to draw these charts in your maths also. Then next is a bar chart. This also you know very well. A bar chart displays comparison between the individual values. The next type of chart is a pie chart. A pie chart represents a circle that contains percentage of all the data values. In a pie chart, each value is represented by a part of a pie. Thus, each chart can be compared to the whole. So you may see the example of this pie chart in your geography textbook, that is the division of land and water on earth, or components of gases in the air, that is shown in your EVAs or maybe in a geography. The next is a donut chart. This type of chart represent data in the form of ring, similar to a pie chart. It contains percentage of all the data values but can display multiple data series. So like here, this is a pie chart and this is a pie chart and this is donut chart. Next is a scatter chart. This type of chart shows the relationship between numerical set of values using x and y axis. And next is a area chart. An area chart is similar to the line chart. The area below the lines are filled with different colors. In an area chart, we can compare the difference between the various series of value. So these are the types of charts. Next is components of chart. See this figure. This figure shows you components of two-dimensional chart. So charts may be a two-dimensional or three-dimensional. There are different parts of chart. However, all the components may not be present in all charts. So see here, this is the chart title, then this is data label. This line, horizontal lines are called as a grid lines. This information, this is called as a legend. Then this horizontal axis, it's called as a x-axis, and this vertical axis is called as a y-axis. Then this is a data table and this is the axis title. This is the axis title of x-axis and this is the axis title of y-axis. Okay, so let us understand. Axis is a line drawn to measure values in a chart is called an axis. In two-dimensional chart contain two axes, that are x-axis and y-axis. X-axis is the horizontal axis of chart. It contains category heading for the data in a worksheet, hence it is called as a category axis. While the y-axis, it is a vertical axis of chart. It contains values of each data point in a worksheet, hence it is also called as a value axis. Remember, y-axis is also called as a value axis, while x-axis is also called as a category axis. Next is axis title. It is the name given to an axis based on the data it contains. Now next is a chart title. It represents the name of chart based on the data it contains. It is placed at the top of a chart. Now next is a data label. It represents the actual data values with the help of which we draw that chart. The next is plot area. It is a rectangular area between two axes. It has no walls. Then next component is a grid lines. These lines extend from x-axis and y-axis across the plot area in a chart. We can show or hide grid lines based on our requirement. And the last component is a legend. It shows the name of different data series and colors or patterns applied to them. So it gives you the name of the data that is shown in that chart. Next is a data table. Now data table contains the data in a tabular format. Additional components of three-dimensional chart. So that these above components are of two-dimensional chart. Now in case of three-dimensional, we have a walls. These are called as a walls, and this is called as a floor. So floor, it is the base area on the xy plane of a 3D chart. So horizontal base, that is called as a floor. While wall, it is a vertical area like y-axis area, that is xy and yz planes of 3D charts. Now the number of data points in data series of 2D chart is limited. We can add 32,000 data points in a 2D chart. Now dear student, here is a note. In 3D chart, the plot area is made up of two walls and one floor area. So here this is one floor area and two walls, like this is one wall and the sleeping is another wall. So it has two walls and one floor area. Okay dear student, in the next lesson we will study how to create a chart. Now your homework is to write types of chart which are given on page number 21 in your computer notebook. Thank you my dear students.